in line. I prayed for you before I called you mine. Oh, I can't believe it's true. To love you, it's the best thing that I'll ever do. I get to love you, it's a promise I'm making to you. Whatever may come, your heart I will choose. Forever I'm yours, forever I do. I get to love you, I get to love you. The way you love, it changes who I am. Can't believe it's true sometimes. Oh, I can't believe it's true. I get to love you, it's the best thing. Whatever may come, your heart I will choose. Forever I'm yours, forever I do. I get to love you, I get to love you, I get to love you, I get to love you.
Take it. If she gives you her heart, don't you break it. Let your arms be a place she feels safe in. She's the best thing that you'll ever have. She always has trouble falling asleep, and she likes to cuddle while under the sheets. She loves pop songs and dancing, bad trash TV. There's still a few other things. She loves love notes and babies, and likes giving gifts. Has a hard time accepting a good compliment. And she loves her whole family and all of her friends. So if you're the one she lets in, take it. If she gives you her, don't you break it. Let your arms be a place she feels safe in. She's the best thing that you'll ever have. She'll love you if you love her on days when it feels like the whole world might cave in. Stand side by side and you'll make it. She's the best thing that you'll ever have. She'll love you if you love her like that.
side by side and you'll make it. She's the best thing that you'll ever have. She'll love you if you love her like that.
family and friends, you've been invited here today to share with Ashton and Taylor a very important moment in their lives, the moment they may become husband and wife. Today is about love, the love between the two people before you, the power of love to heal and to transform, and the notion that with love, all things are possible. Marriage is an act of faith and ever-deepening commitment, as well as a loving union between a man and a woman. It has been described as the best and the most important relationship that two people can share, the creation of a single growing energy of spiritual life. On behalf of Ashton and Taylor, thank you for joining us. They're delighted that you've come to share the beginning of their new life together. Some of you have traveled great distances to be here. Your presence today shows support for their union, and the endorsement of loved ones and friends makes this an immensely joyous day. Each person present today has influenced their lives for the better. The time and conversations that you've had with Ashton and Taylor, even before they met, have helped them to become the individuals who they needed to be first, so then they could find each other. This is also a time to celebrate and remember all of those loved ones who have touched their lives, but are not able to be here in person, but who are most certainly with us in spirit. Let us remember them as well on this wonderful day. Taylor and Ashton, today you're taking into your care and trust the happiness of the one person in this whole world who you love with all your heart, each other. You're agreeing to share life's deepest and richest experiences. You're adding to your life not only the affection of each other, but also the companionship and blessing of mutual respect. You've invited these guests to share in the celebration of your love, a love that now culminates in your union as husband and wife. When you enter into marriage, you enter into life's most important relationship. It is a gift given to bring comfort when there is sorrow, peace when there is unrest, laughter when there is happiness, and love when it is shared. Real love goes far beyond the feelings of romance and bliss. It's caring more about the well-being and happiness of your marriage partner than your own needs and desires. Love makes burdens lighter because you have someone to help you carry them. It makes joys more intense because you have someone with whom to share them. It makes you stronger so you can become involved with life in ways you dare not risk alone. Real love says you're stronger together than when you're apart. Let us pray. Dear God, we ask your blessing on Taylor and Ashton as they begin this new adventure together. Grant them patience, humility, and faithfulness. You help deepen their love and are with them this special moment as they enter into their marriage. We ask that you stay by their side in the days ahead. May they always treasure their friendship as much as their passion. When they encounter challenges, may they always remember the healing powers of a hug or a laugh or saying, I love you. May they rest in the knowledge that no matter what struggles they may encounter, by holding on to each other and keeping their eyes on you, they will always come to find the strength they need to succeed on their journey together. We know you rejoice as this covenant is made and pray for your continued grace and mercy to cover this new family. Amen. Taylor and Ashton, a successful marriage isn't something that just happens. It takes effort, it takes faith, but most importantly, it takes a commitment from both of you. Ashton, the woman who stands before you is about to become your wife. She will look to you for comfort, support, understanding, encouragement, and protection. You must never take her for granted and always consider her along with yourself. Do you take this woman to be your wife? Do you promise to love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, through good times and difficult ones, so long as you both shall live?
I do.
Taylor, the man that stands before you is about to become your husband. He will look to you for comfort, support, understanding, encouragement, and protection. You must never take him for granted and always consider him along with yourself. Do you take this man to be your husband? Do you promise to love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, through good times and difficult ones, so long as you both shall live?
I do.
For those of you who don't know, and for those of you who do, playing cards hold a very special meaning for Taylor and Ashton. In fact, Ashton asked her to be his girlfriend and then proposed to her using a deck of playing cards. So it's not only fitting, but it means so much to Taylor and Ashton that they would like all of you to write your well wishes and marriage advice on a playing card that's on the table in the back before you leave this evening. I'd now like to introduce Tabitha Foley, sister of the bride, who will read a wedding prayer.
Today is the beginning. In the years that lie ahead, may you always share the love you have. This day as you are wed, I pray you'll each be on whom the other can depend, and may you share not only love, but be each other's friends. Some hopes may not be realized, some dreams may not come true, but many of them will, I know, to bless the two of you. Within the home that you will have, I pray you'll always find contentment, joy, security, good health, and peace of mind.
And now it is time for you to exchange your vows. Sir, you will go first.
Thank you. Taylor, I never thought I would marry someone that I met as a child. It turns out that love isn't always at first sight. A true love takes time. Growing up, I always admired your intelligence, drive, and caring nature. Now that we are older, I admire so much more about you. You are beautiful, loving, nurturing, fun, spontaneous, adventurous, quirky, family-oriented, always ready for a good time, would do anything for anyone, and an absolutely incredible cook, just to say a few. You are the person I want to spend the rest of my life with, raise children with, and grow old with. You have brought so much joy to my life, a joy that will never end. When I am with you, I feel at peace, and I know I'm home. On our deepest level, we are the same person. Our goals, upbringings, and life philosophies, faith, and love for others are perfectly aligned. We understand one another even in hard times. We love each other even when we don't love ourselves. And we will always be there for one another through all that life throws at us. That is why I promise to always laugh at your jokes even when they're only kind of funny. I promise to always be honest, loyal, and respectful. I promise to support your dreams as if they were my own. I promise to care for you when you're sick, to carry your worries when you're upset, and to love you unconditionally. I promise to be there for you during all of life's moments, the ones that bring us laughter and the ones that bring us tears. I promise to share my life with you, my heart with you, and my dreams with you. I promise to cherish you all of my days. I can't wait to create endless memories with you by my side and continue to build our unforgettable story. Here's to the greatest adventure yet. I love you.
Ashton, I wish I could say that I knew you were the one from the very first day I met you, but my six-year-old self had absolutely no clue the impact that you would have on my life. About 15 years later, after smiling at each other in the hallways for years and then going our separate ways for college, we decided to give each other a chance. That was by far the best decision ever, and it will forever change our lives. I know for certain that you are the best thing that has ever happened to me. You have shown me what love truly is, and I cannot wait to experience all that life has to offer with you by my side. Today is a reminder how complete you make my life. It is also a reminder of every laugh that we have shared, every good and tough situation we have been through together, and every exciting moment there is to come. There are so many reasons why I know that you are the one that I want to spend the rest of my life with. You are by far the most caring, supportive, motivated, optimistic, and humble person that I know. You exceed all of my expectations, and you make me a better person each and every day. I know that in you, I did not simply find a husband, but more importantly, my best friend. I promise to show you every day how appreciative I am of all that you do and to support you in all that you choose to do throughout life. To step away from my stubbornness and accept that I, to my dismay, am not always right. I promise to always treat you like an equal partner in our relationship. To always do the little things that make you happy, even if it means going on a long bike ride or cleaning the house. I promise to always make you laugh and to encourage you to step beyond your comfort zone every once in a while. To always be loyal and to honor and cherish you through all of life's adventures. But most importantly, I promise to love you unconditionally each and every day of our lives. I choose you and I promise to choose you throughout all of life. I will laugh with you, cry with you, and grow with you. You love me in ways I never knew possible, and I will strive each day to make you feel the same. I am truly the luckiest girl in the world to be standing here with you today. I love you, and I cannot wait to build a wonderful life together.
Our next reader, Tiffany Kirchy, another sister of the bride, will come forward to read a wedding blessing.
An Irish wedding blessing. May your mornings bring joy and your evenings bring peace. May your troubles grow few as your blessings increase. May the saddest day of your future be no worse than the happiest day of your past. May your hands be forever clasped in friendship and your hearts joined forever in love. Your lives are very special. God has touched you in many ways. May his blessings rest upon you and fill all of your coming days.
Taylor and Ashton, you're about to present a ring to each other. The wedding ring, a complete circle, is a symbol of the completeness a husband and wife find in a marriage relationship. The circle is a symbol of eternity. It has no beginning, no ending, and no point of weakness. Taylor and Ashton, may your love be as everlasting as these precious rings. May they signify your love, trust, and faithfulness to one another. In the years to come, may they remind you of the magnificent joy of this special occasion, and may you always be as happy together as you are today. Taylor?
Taylor.
With this ring.
With this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
I offer you my hand.
I offer you my hand.
And my heart.
My heart.
As I know.
As I know.
They will be safe with you.
They will be safe with you.
All that I am.
All that I am.
I give to you.
I give to you.
And all that I have.
All that I have.
I share with you.
I share with you.
The engagement ring is a symbol of promise and intention. The promise has been fulfilled and the intention's been met. Ashton, will you please place your engagement ring over Taylor's wedding band to show that the love that brought you together will protect and sustain your marriage. Ashton?
Ashton.
With this ring.
With this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
I offer you my hand.
I offer you my hand.
And my heart.
And my heart.
As I know.
As I know.
They will be safe with you.
They will be safe with you.
All that I am.
All that I am.
I give to you.
I give to you.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I share with you.
I share with you.
Taylor and Ashton, give to one another new experiences of joy. Challenge one another so that you may grow. May the love you hold for each other, now sealed in marriage, continue to mature with the passing years. May you never take each other for granted, but always experience the wonder of your union. Be slow to anger, quick to forgive, leaving no tracks of resentment behind each day. May the love consist not only in gazing into each other's eyes, but in looking outward in the same direction. And may your life together be a source of strength and inspiration to yourselves, your families, your friends, and to all whose lives you touch. By the love that's brought you here today, by the integrity of your commitment, and by the vows and rings you've just exchanged before God and this company of beloved family and friends, it is my absolute joy, honor, and privilege as an ordained minister to pronounce that you are now husband and wife. I kiss your bride.
Ladies and gentlemen, please stand and help me to welcome Mr. and Mrs. Ashton Rodman.
Bow break, let it come down crash. The sun fade out to a dark sky. Can't say I'd even notice it was absent. Cause I could live by the light in your eyes. Unfold before you. Strong together, the very first words of a lifelong a love letter. Tell the world that we finally got it all right. I choose you. I will become yours and you will become mine. I choose.
Thank you. sunshine in the darkest days, my better half, my saving grace. You make me who I wanna be. You make it easy. You took all my rough around the edges, never let it ruffle up your feathers, angel. Yeah, I'm down for life. You got me wrapped around your finger, and I like it just in case you can't tell. You make it easy. Loving up on you, make it easy with every little thing you do. You're my sunshine in the darkest days, my better half, my saving grace. You make me.
With your bride and groom.
All right, everybody. Hello, hello. How we doing tonight, guys? Hello, everybody. How we doing tonight, guys? That's what I like to hear. Thank you guys so much for being here and being a part of this very special day celebrating Taylor and Ashton. We're going to bring in some very important people, but before we do that, I would like to acknowledge some very important people. If we could please start with a huge round of applause for the grandparents of the bride, Joseph Cottage. If we could have Joseph Cottage, please be acknowledged. Hi, Joseph. And grandparents of the groom, Jim and Faith Rodman and Gail McBennett. A huge round of applause for them, guys. All right, the bride and groom would also like to acknowledge their grandparents who have passed on but are most definitely here today in spirit. So please keep that applause going for grandmother of the bride, Elizabeth Betty Cottage. Let's hear it one more time for grandfather coming over here, guys. All right, a couple more people in memoriam here. Grandparents of the bride, Thomas and Edna Foley Sr., everybody. And last but certainly not least in memoriam today, please, a round of applause for our grandfather of the groom, Robert McBennett, everybody. All right, guys, now we are going to bring in some very important people. Please, a huge round of applause. The parents of your bride tonight, Tom and Nancy Foley. Keep it going for Tom and Nancy, everybody. Tom just wants to keep the party going. All right, guys, and now we're going to hear from the other side. Let's get a huge round of applause going for parents of the groom tonight, Eric and April Rodman.
Get
back in April, everybody. Keep it going for them. All right, you heard these two give some amazing readings earlier during the ceremony. Here's a different flavor for you. Sisters of the Bride tonight, please make some noise for Tabitha Foley and Tiffany Churchy. Once more for Tabitha and Tiffany, everybody. All right, guys, and they are little, but they are mighty. Let's get a huge round of applause for our ring bearer, Jackson Baker. And then we also got our junior ridesman and junior groomsman, Riley Gurchy, Blake Gurchy, and Jace Baker. Going for those little and mighty souls, everybody. All right, we're gonna bring in our bridal party here. Can I hear you get loud before we do bring them in? All right, guys, let's keep that going for bridesmen and groomsmen Jordan Baker and William Robinson. Let's hear it once more for Jordan and William, everybody. All right, guys, next up we have two more very important people. Please keep it going now for Kaylee Meyer and Michael Gilbert. Everybody, once more, let's hear it for them. All right, guys, we're gonna get wild for this one. We might have to hear this one again later in the evening. Who's to say? Please make some noise for your bridesmaids and groomsmen. We got Juliana Niles and we got Brandon Dunson, everybody. One more time for Juliana and Brandon, everybody! All right, guys, next up we have two more very important people. Keep this going for Giovanna Brayman and Trent Brayman! One more time, everybody, for Giovanna and Trent. All right, guys, we got a couple more here. Let's make some noise now. We got Kayla Rodman and Derek Gilbert, everybody. One more time for Kayla and Derek, everybody. All right, and these two are really bringing something special back, that is for sure. Let's air it for your matron of honor and groomsmen, Haley Bonacci and Zachary Numsen. Everybody, once more for them. All right, guys, just a few more. We are keeping the power going here tonight. All right, guys, a huge round of applause for your maid of honor and best man, Brittany Finch and Brian Gilmer. Let's hear it for Benny and Brian, everybody! All right, guys, now I need you to get real loud. Let's bring this place to the ground for the first time in public, the guests of honor tonight, Mr. and Mrs. Ashton Rodman!
I had a dream so big and loud, I jumped so high, I touched the clouds, whoa, oh, 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 oh.
once more for Taylor and Ashton, everybody. Our way into our first dance here. Survival party, stay right where you are. Here is a first dance with our bride and groom.
I can't count the times, almost said what's on my mind, but I didn't. Just the other day, I wrote down all the things I'd say, but I couldn't, I just couldn't. Baby, I know that you've been wondering, so here goes nothing, in case you didn't know, baby. I said that I could live this life without you.
Bridal party, please join your bride and groom on the dance floor for the final part of our song here. One more round of applause for Taylor, Ashton, and their bridal party. All right, bridal party, you can take your seats at this time, except for Taylor and Tom. Please stay up there. All right, now here we have a very special song that Taylor was telling me that, you know, Tom used to sing to her when she was a kid, and it's a very special song for them. So please, a very warm round of applause as we go into a little father-daughter dance here.
Dropped to my knees by her mind.
Applause for Taylor and Tom, everybody. Absolutely beautiful. All right, now if we could have April please join your son on the dance floor. Let's have a huge round of applause for them, everybody. April and Ashton.
The days come easy and the moments pass slow, and each road leads you where you wanna go. And if you're faced with a choice and you have to choose, I hope you choose the one that means the most to you. And if one door opens to another door closed, I hope you keep on walking till you find the window. If it's cold outside, show the world the warmth of your smile. But more than anything, more than anything, my wish for you is that this life becomes all that you wanted to. Your dreams stay big, your worries stay small. You never need to carry more than you can hold. And while you're out there getting where you're getting to, I hope you know somebody loves you and wants the same things too. Yeah, I think
Let's hear it for Ashton and April, everybody. All right, guys, and before we begin with our dinner here this evening, Tom Foley would like to say a few more words, so can I hear it one more time for Tom, a little welcome toast here. Beautiful dance with his daughter.
Hello, everyone. You know I got a big mouth, but I still need a mic. And I need glasses. Welcome, everyone. You all know I'm Tom Foley, Taylor's dad. First, I'd like to thank God for joining Taylor and Ashton on this beautiful day. Second, I'd like to thank you, all of you people, for coming. I appreciate it and joining us here today. And third, I'd like to thank April and Eric Rodman and the Rodman family for joining us. Well, as you can see, my Taylor has turned out to be a beautiful, amazing young lady because of the influence of three great women in Taylor's life. My mom, Edna Foley, my mother-in-law, Betty Cottage, who I know are watching from heaven today, and my beautiful wife, Nancy. Great job. And great job to all three ladies. So Ashton, you chose a great one with my Taylor. So as Taylor was growing up, from the time she could walk, she was a handful. She was determined to try everything and excel at it. As a dad, I remember playing Barbie dolls with her, hopscotch, jump rope, bike riding. I taught her how to ride a bike. Wiffle ball and swimming, those were the days. We played a lot of school in our house and games, thanks to Nancy. All in our yard, yeah, we did it. And we had fun doing it. I had a lot of hopes and dreams for Taylor. And hopes and dreams do come true. She was a singer and a dancer, and our yard was a stage. As Taylor got older, we would play hoops and catch, like I do with the grandsons and the granddaughter. We went fishing, archery, shot BB guns. She was better than me. We'd watch a lot of movies, and I always told her that dreams do come true. And that was from The Wizard of Oz. Everybody knows that movie. One of mine and Taylor and Aunt Nancy's favorite movies. As a dad, I always hoped and I prayed that her dreams would come true. I needed this cheat sheet anyway. So when Taylor graduated high school, I gave her a book by Dr. Seuss called Oh, the Places You'll Go. And that was 7 years ago, and she has a master's degree in teaching. She teaches special ed. She has traveled the country and overseas, and her faith has brought her and Taylor and Ashton together today. Oh, the places you'll go. And when Taylor first brought Ashton home, me and Nancy knew he was something special, as you can see. Her smile and her laugh was a little brighter, and I knew he was something special for my baby. Could this really be the same boy she went to grade school with and sat on a school bus with his mug at the window every day? They sat next to each other playing chorus and clarinet. He was a special kid, but I really didn't know him. I could see he was a gentleman and had faith in God and had goals just like my girl Taylor. As time marched on, their love grew stronger and became best friends, which brings us to this day, today, to the celebration of this couple. Thinking of their love brings me back to the day of Taylor growing up. The advice I gave her, don't talk to strangers. Don't trust anybody. Always say no, the easiest word in the world. Don't cry over spilt milk. And an uppercut and a left jab is the best punch. And always help, always hold your head up high. And always wave an American flag in your front yard. And always be humble, which I know she is. But when Taylor gave me some advice, being a dad of three girls, it ain't easy. She would say, "Dad, man up. And Dad, don't pee off the porch." Did I listen? I don't know. You've got to figure that out. So Taylor, thanks for the advice. So Taylor, me and Mom love you to the moon and back. So proud of you and Ashton. Make a great couple with love, friendship, and laughter. So Taylor, from one of our favorite movies, The Wizard of Oz, is a song your grandmothers and your mother sang to you. And I sang to you. Somewhere over the rainbow. And Taylor, dreams do come true. Bluebirds do fly. And may all your troubles melt like lemon drops. And Taylor, dreams that you dream of do come true. It's here today. This is one of your many rainbows. So I'd like to bring Taylor's mom up, my beautiful wife, Nancy, for a toast to Taylor and Ashton Rodman. And please raise your glass. And from the Bible, God gave us faith, hope, and love. And the greatest is love. Amen. And cheers to Taylor and Ashton. Amen. Cheers.
Let's hear it for the Foleys, everybody. Keep that going. All right, guys, we are going to have some appetizers coming out in just a minute here. So sit tight, and we'll hear from some more very important people in just a few minutes. Thanks, everybody. All right, everybody. If I didn't introduce myself earlier, my name is Mac. I'm the DJ tonight. So thank you guys again so much for being here. If you want to hear something later, feel free to let me know. I'll let you know if it's a good choice. Thank you guys again so much for being here. Where are we coming from today? Raise your hand if you're coming just from New York today. New Yorkers, hello, hello. Nice spread across the board. Raise your hand if you're coming from somewhere else, a different state. Where are we coming from here? Arizona, make some noise for Arizona. How about you guys back there? Where are you coming from? Where was it? Massachusetts, okay, all right. Now you got to see some Florida, is that what you said? Or that girl with the blonde hair is from Florida, everybody. All right, guys. Well, thank you guys so much for being here. We are going to hear from a few more important people. Well, I'm going to see if I can get these guys' attention. Hey, guys. Hi. We're going to hear from some very important people. I just want to make sure we can all hear, okay? Thank you guys so much. They're taking selfies with Hawaiian shirts back there. They're on another level. I'll see them on the dance floor later. All right, guys, thank you again for being here. We are going to hear first off from our best man. He's one of Ashton's best friends, everybody. Let's hear it for Brian Kilmer, everybody.
Oh, boy. All right. Ooh, that's funny. All right. Good evening, everybody. How are you all doing tonight? Doing good? Feeling well? All right. It's a little lame, but we'll let it slide. That's what I like to hear. So I just want to start out. As you've probably heard, I am Brian. I'm the best man. And appreciations to Ashton for bestowing that title upon me. And also for allowing me to be up here and perform everyone's favorite task, which is, of course, public speaking. So, but in all seriousness, having the chance to stand up here and get to say a few words about Ashton and his bride. Hi, Taylor. There's a lot of feelings, and I can't really describe them, but they're all good, mostly. So, a little history lesson. Ashton and I, we met in seventh grade and really became friends in eighth. High school life was about what you'd expect. It was pretty terrible. Not much to report on, you know, we'd go to classes together, eat lunch together, we had it the same period. But other than that, you know, at the end of the day, we'd go our separate ways and just do it all again the next. Probably the most memorable thing throughout high school was before a concert, Ashton and I, on our lunch periods, would actually go down to the music wing and staple together the programs for those concerts. It wasn't much, but I'm pretty sure the scholarship that we received at the end of senior year was definitely for that, so that was pretty cool, free money. So, on behalf of Ashton and I, to all the parents and anybody else who attended those concerts from 2012 to 15, you're welcome. So, things really started to pick up after college, picked up between us more than it really ever had. Over the past 2 years, I've been invited out to countless game nights, holiday parties, and just going to hang out, you know? Oh boy. You know? Huh? Am I missing something? Oh. Come on, Kayla. But the effort that Ashton and Taylor put into hosting at their apartment and just everything else they do, it's really nothing short of amazing. You know, they make everybody feel welcome and comfortable, and that's something that I personally can really appreciate. Knowing what I do now, you know, I'm kind of disappointed in myself that I hadn't reached back out to them sooner, but, you know, that's on me. Now, they've really made me a changed person, you know, introducing me to social situations and allowing me to go out and meet and become friends with a lot of great people. You know, it really showed me what I'd been missing out on for a majority of my life. You know, so thank you for that. You know, honestly, without them liking me enough to invite me into their social circle, thinking about it, I'd be pretty afraid of where I'd be right now in life without them. So, again, thank you. I'm sorry. I failed everybody, but I need the paper. I know, I'm sorry, I failed you all. Okay. Yep. Uh-huh. Got that. All right. So yeah, I know I'm not the only one that knows how great these two are. You know, I'm sure everyone, or mostly everybody, can attest to how great and amazing these two are and just the energy that they provide. You know, being able to bring each other up as well as everybody else around them is really something extraordinarily special. You know? So, and because of their bond that they share, I'm ecstatic, proud, and very honored to be able to say, Ashton and Taylor, I wish you nothing but the best, a life full of love and happiness between you two. You guys really deserve it, and I love you guys. So, to wrap it all up, hey, sit down. All right, so to wrap it all up, I welcome you all to join me in raising a glass to celebrate my best friend and his beautiful wife. All right, congratulations to the new Mr. and Mrs. Rodman. All righty. It's good to go
there. One more time for Brian, everybody. All right, Brian, sit down. There we go. All right, now we are going to hear from our maid of honor tonight, another best friend. Please, a huge round of applause for Brittany Finch, everybody. Someone get this girl her glass. There we go. Keep it going. Round of applause, everybody. Here she comes.
I'm going to catch on fire again. For those of you who saw that. what? Okay. All right, so hi everyone. I hope you're all having a wonderful time so far this evening. I first want to start off by saying thank you to everyone for joining us on this very special day in honor of Taylor and Ashton. I know it means the world to them to kick off the beginning of their new life together, being surrounded by the people that they love the most. So thank you all. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Brittany, and I'm Taylor's maid of honor and best friend. Taylor and I met during our junior year of high school about 8 years ago when we sat next to each other in study hall. At that point in time, we were both pretty shy and quiet, so I'm not sure which one of us was the one brave enough to break the ice and say, hey, me? Okay. Prototypical. But I'm so grateful for that tiny act of courage, because once we started talking, we became best friends instantly, and over the years that followed, we formed an unbreakable bond that'll last a lifetime. Now, I'm not much of a savvy type, but I do have to tell y'all a little bit about how extraordinary of a person Taylor is. Throughout the years, I've seen that shy, quiet girl from high school flourish into such a strong, smart, confident, ambitious, and dedicated person who continuously inspires those lucky enough to know her. Not to mention, she's also one of the funniest people I know, but I could be biased because we do have the same weird sense of humor. We used to stay up all night during our sleepovers making music videos of us breakdancing together in matching cheetah print footy pajamas. Good times. When I think about our friendship, I think about laughing to the point we can't breathe. I think about road trips and singing at the top of our lungs. I think of all the places we've traveled together, including both Disney parks in Florida and California, making the necessary stops to Harry Potter World so Taylor could add another wand to her collection. But most importantly, when I think about Taylor, I think about how proud I am of the person she is and how lucky I am to have found a best friend that I consider more like a sister. When I first met Ashton, all I knew about him was that he had gone to the same school that Taylor and I went to, and that he was also pretty shy and quiet, from what I could tell. But as I got to know him, I was surprised to find out that I couldn't have been more wrong. As I was third wheeling a lot of Taylor and Ashton's hangouts, I saw Ashton really come out of his shell, and I can honestly say that I couldn't imagine a more perfect match for my best friend. He's super smart, kind, supportive, and driven, but I'd have to say that my favorite thing about him is that he matches mine and Taylor's goofy personalities. I'm not sure how good of a breakdancer he is, but I've definitely seen some interesting moves that I'm hoping to see more of later on the dance floor tonight. You better break them out. But on a serious note, I want to thank Ashton for being Taylor's rock, for supporting her and loving her through thick and thin, and for bringing so much happiness into her life just by being you. There's no one else I'd rather share the title of best friend with. When I look at Taylor and Ashton as a couple, I see so much to be admired. They're so supportive of one another, so in sync with what's important to them, their family, friends, and their cat Ginny, being at the top of the list. And most importantly, they share an unconditional love that proves they're right where they're supposed to be. I love you both so much, and I'm so honored to have a place by your side as you begin your life together. So please join me in raising a glass to the beautiful couple, to a lifetime of endless love, laughter, and adventure.
One more time for our maid of honor, Brittany, everybody. Brittany, I almost changed your entrance song to the Alicia Keys jam. This girl is on fire. I'm good. I'm glad we're on the same page. All right, guys, we have one more toast. And now we are going to hear from the sister of our groom tonight. Please, a huge round of applause. Last but definitely not least, Kayla Rodman, everybody.
Oh gosh. Good evening. I hope you're all having a great time tonight. I can't be like Brian and just, you know, not have my phone in front of me, so don't mind me. For anyone who may not know me, I'm Kayla, Ashton's little sister. When Taylor and Ashton asked me to give a speech, I was very honored because I've watched their love story firsthand over the years. I remember when Ashton first came to me to talk about Taylor. He was never the one to date or to brag about girls, So when he walked into my room one night after hanging out with her a few times, he told me he wanted to ask her to be his girlfriend. Remember what I said? Yeah? I said, you're 100% positive about this, right? You could see yourself marrying this girl after about maybe 2 to 3 times hanging out with her. Well, he said yes, and here we are today on your wedding day. Growing up, you were always my role model, Ashton. I wanted to be as smart as you, and that never worked because every time you tried to help me, I would always ignore you. Ashton was always the golden child, and my parents are probably so proud that they had such a well-behaved kid, and then I came along. Sorry. Someone's got to be the black sheep of the family, you know. I think the only bad thing that Ashton's ever done was when we would ride our quads up and down our grandmother's driveway, and we would go full speed after our father just yelled at us. And then when he couldn't see us anymore, we would just keep going. And guess who got in trouble? It was me, never Ashton. Oh, and how could I forget the time that he buried my Hannah Montana CD because he was sick of listening to it? I'm just getting over that. When we hit the teen years, I didn't think it was cool to hang out with my brother, and I was never home. Until a few years ago, I realized that my one true friend was always you. Oh God, I decided I wasn't gonna do this. And I'm glad that we spend as much time as we do together now. Oh God. I'm sorry. Ashton, you're truly my best friend. We've always had a bond that a lot of people wish they had with their siblings. When you and Taylor first started dating, and then eventually moved out, I was upset I was gonna lose my best friend. Well, I was extremely wrong. Not only did I get to keep you as my best friend, I gained another one. I'm glad you and I get to share the title of Ashton's best friend. It took about a year for me to let my guard down and trust you because you know I've always been the protective little sister. Taylor, the relationship you and I have together is so special to me, and I couldn't be happier to call you my sister-in-law, even though I considered you a sister a long time ago. We have formed a genuine friendship that wasn't just forced because you're with my brother, and I cherish that every day, which I know you weren't expecting because you were more scared to meet me than my parents. If I ever need a place to go or to get away, Ashton and Taylor always welcome me and my friends for constant laughs, a good time, staying up until 1 a.m., getting caught up in conversations. Nancy, you told Taylor she shouldn't be mean to me, and I hate to break it to you, but she is. But, yes, it couldn't match my personality any better. You both have the biggest hearts, and you're truly a perfect match for each other. I've never seen my brother as happy as he is when he's with you. I couldn't imagine a more beautiful, caring, down-to-earth girl than you. 10 out of 10. That's a joke from the bachelorette party. You bring out a different side in him, and he does the same for you. All I've ever wanted for Ashton was a girl who wouldn't take advantage of his kindness, because he deserves the best, and you are the best, Taylor. I can't tell you guys much about love because of all my failed relationships, but what I can tell you is what Ashton and Taylor have is love. With two completely different personalities, Ashton being the calm and Taylor being the crazy, they complement each other and encourage each other to try new things and get out of their comfort zones. Like every relationship, there will always be arguments, which if you ask me, it's always over the smallest things, because I think Taylor gets bored and likes to stir the pot to keep Ashton on his toes. Ashton, don't laugh. You're not innocent here either. You definitely keep her on her toes as well. Just remember, happy wife, happy life. Make sure to kill all the spiders or you'll be sleeping in a hotel room. There will always be challenges, as all relationships do, but the best part of love and marriage is growing together, caring for each other, helping each other, and most importantly, being patient with each other, which I know is extremely hard for the both of you. My advice to you, be kind to each other, always forgive, make sure you're both happy, and always be there for each other through all the good times, but especially the bad. Today, I want to thank both of you for being a part of my life and to celebrate the love you share. Now let's all raise our glasses to the new bride and groom and wish them a lifetime of love and happiness to Taylor and Ashton.
Let's hear it once more for Kayla, everybody. All right, guys. Entrees will be out in just a minute here. Continue to enjoy the evening. All right. Who made the first move? That was unanimous. Unanimous. All right, guys. Now we're getting a little more personal. Who has a better sense of humor? There we go. All right, 1-1. We are even. Who has the worst temper of the two of you? Ah. Took a minute, but he agrees. He agrees. All right, I know it's been a long time, guys, but who was the first to say I love you? There we go. I see who's making the moves here. Ah, ha, ha. All right, who is the pickier eater when you guys go out? Wow, you guys are just, it's like they really have known each other for a long time, isn't it, guys? All right, who spends more money between the two of you? A brief hesitation, but then, yeah, of course. All right, controversial. Whose family is more fun? Oh, that's the right answer. That's the polite answer. Well done. All right. I was asked to keep it appropriate, but I think we can do this one. Who is the better kisser? I think that's our first split. There we go. All right. Who is more stubborn of the two of you? Okay. What if I rephrase it this way? Who is more patient? More patient. There we go. We can agree on that one, can't we? All right, awesome. Who is the messy one? There we go. I love that. All right, who is the most likely to say I'm sorry after things get tough? Okay, there we go. The hesitation is so funny. All right, guys, just a few more questions here. Who's more likely to eat the last cookie or chip? Get those sweets. All right, guys, who is more romantic? Oh, wow. I don't think we've seen that yet. I like that. All right. Who takes longer to get ready when you guys have somewhere to be? I saw you peeking. I saw you peeking. All right. Who wants kids more? It might be the same answer, but who loves the other spouse more? Give your bride and groom a round of applause, guys. Beautiful answers to these questions. All right, guys. Well, you guys can put your shoes back on. We'll clear the dance floor. I'm going to open up the dance floor here in just a little bit, all right? So I'd love to see you guys out here. We'll do cake cutting, some other stuff in just a little bit. But otherwise, I'll see you on the dance floor in a few minutes, everybody.
Open up the champagne, pop. It's my house, come on, turn it up. Hear a knock on the door and the night begins. 'Cause we've done this before, so you come on in. Make yourself at my home, tell me where you've been. Pour yourself something cold, baby, cheers to this. Sometimes you gotta stay in, and you know where I live. Yeah, you know what we is. Sometimes you gotta stay in. Welcome to my house. Baby, take control now. We can't even slow down. Morning comes and you know that you wanna stay. Close the blinds, let's pretend that the time has changed. Keep our clothes on the floor, open up champagne. Let's continue tonight, come on, celebrate.
That's how we do.
Sometimes you gotta stay in, and you know where I live. Yeah, you know what we is. Sometimes you gotta stay. Welcome to my house, baby, take control now. We can't even slow down, we don't have to go.
down.